Brand new trial out looking at different exercises to lower blood pressure. They recruited around 300 people with pre-hypertension, meaning they all had systolic blood pressure over 120 millimeters mercury or diastolic over 80. The current classification in the U.S. is normal blood pressure is under 120 systolic and under 80 diastolic. Elevated is 120 to 129 and still under 80 diastolic. Hypertension starts at 130 systolic, and stage 1 is 130 to 139, or 80 to 89 diastolic, and then stage 2 hypertension is over 140 or over 90 diastolic. In Europe, it's a little different. Hypertension starts at 140 systolic, 90 diastolic. Under 120 is optimal, 120 to 130 is normal, and 130 to 140 is considered high normal. To some extent, it's semantics. But in both places, under 120 systolic is considered optimal. And so the participants were above that. So these 300 or so people were split randomly into two groups. One was put on a cardio program, which is pretty standard recommendation. So things like jogging, brisk walking, cycling, climbing stairs. And the other half was put on a Tai Chi program. Some people may not be familiar with that. I know we have viewers from a little bit all over the world. Tai Chi is this unique martial art from China that's practiced typically with slow movements. When you see these images of groups of people in parks doing these synchronized movements, almost like a dance, that's Tai Chi. There's already plenty of evidence that Tai Chi can help lower blood pressure. So in this trial, they wanted to test directly head-to-head Tai Chi to cardio. Both groups did their respective exercises in one-hour sessions, four times a week. And each session consisted of 10 minutes of warm-up, 40 minutes of the activity per se, and then 10 minutes of cool-down. The trial lasted 1 year, and there was no significant difference between the two groups in caloric intake or total physical activity. So this is good because it rules out some trivial explanations like they were just eating differently or just spending more calories, burning more calories in one of the groups. It's not that. So it actually allows us to zone in on these two different types of exercise. Both programs successfully lowered blood pressure, and Tai Chi had a stronger effect. In average, a reduction of 7 points, 7 millimeters mercury in the Tai Chi group, and 4.6 on cardio. Now, these measurements are done at rest in a medical office after a period of 10 minutes or so of rest. So it's not just an effect acutely right after exercise. It's actually a sustained lasting effect over the course of the day. In fact, they also measured their 24-hour average systolic blood pressure. So not just the one-time measurement, but this continuous averaged metric. And that was also significantly lower on the Tai Chi group and nighttime systolic blood pressure. So the average systolic blood pressure during the night when participants are resting was also significantly lower on the Tai Chi group, again supporting this idea that it's a sustained lasting benefit, not just something right after exercise. A number of participants were able to bring down their blood pressure to the normal range, to the optimal range under 120 systolic, and that number was larger on the participants doing Tai Chi. 22% of the group doing Tai Chi normalized or optimized their systolic blood pressure compared to 16% on cardio. And other biomarkers like waist circumference, body weight, BMI, lipids like cholesterol and triglycerides, and fasting glucose were not significantly different between the two groups, which is interesting. It tells us that the effect on blood pressure is independent from weight loss and from these other metrics. So it's a really interesting result. Couple caveats. One, individual variation. The numbers we went over are the average for each group, but individual results may vary as always. And in fact, they report that individual variability was quite significant. Also, the cardio modality was a moderate intensity exercise. So it's possible that if someone were doing a more intense type of cardio, a stronger benefit might be seen. Now, why does Tai Chi have this blood pressure lowering effect? Several possibilities. Tai Chi is normally seen as a very relaxing activity, these slow rhythmic movements. Breathing is a big part of Tai Chi. So it's possible that this relaxing quality per se is responsible for this reduction in blood pressure. In fact, there is some evidence that Tai Chi can help quiet down our sympathetic nervous system, kind of our fight or flight modality, and conversely enhance our parasympathetic nervous system, which is more our relaxation mode. So it would make sense that this shift would help lower heart rate and blood pressure. It's also interesting that we recently looked at a systematic analysis of different types of exercise, and the ones that had the strongest effect to lower blood pressure were the so-called isometric exercises, things like planks and wall squats. And it's really interesting to observe that Tai Chi is kind of reminiscent of wall squats with all these bent knee positions that are held for long periods of time. I know Tai Chi looks really easy and light because it's done very slowly, but I used to do this regularly back in my 20s, and holding these bent knee low positions for 40 minutes to an hour can be a pretty good workout for the lower body. So there we go. Tai Chi, another good option on the table for people who like it to help lower blood pressure. Here's that previous video going over all the different types of exercise and blood pressure. And here's a quick diet hack to help lower your blood pressure some more. Check those out. I'll see you next time. Bye.